Glorious morning, children. Welcome to digital classes. How are you, children? How are you? I hope you all are fine and safe, children. Have you finished yesterday's homework, children? Have you finished? I think you all have finished yesterday's homework because you are not going outside. You are staying at home. Children, in our last class, what we discussed, children? We discussed about colorful flowers. You have enjoyed a lot. You said wonderful answers. Really, I felt very happy hearing those answers from you. Okay, children, today also, let us learn interesting topic, children. Pay your attention here. Children, today let us learn about punctuation marks. You know punctuation marks very well, children. Children, look at this sentence. Is there any mistake in this sentence, children? Very good. There is no full stop at the end. There is no full stop at the end. Children, we should keep full stop at the end of the simple sentence, at the end of the statement. Simple statements, simple sentences are called assertive sentences. We should keep full stop at the end of the assertive sentence. Children, look at this sentence. Which type of sentence is it, children? Very good. This is an imperative sentence. We should keep full stop after the imperative sentence. Full stop is used to short forms. Example, Prime Minister, PM, United States of America, USA. In these two short forms, we used full stop. Children, this exclamation mark is used to express a sudden feeling of joy, surprise, sorrow. Children, look at this, another punctuation mark. What is this, children? Very good. This is a comma. We use it for short pause. For short pause. Comma is used in the middle of a sentence to give a short pause. It is used to separate related words in a list. For example, I like apple, mango, grapes, and pears. Comma also used to explain a word. For example, Tommy, my pet dog, is very faithful. Children, here we are explaining about Tommy. Comma also used to separate names of people whom we are referring to. For example, Rohan, please open the door. Comma also used to separate the names of the months from the year. For example, I was born on August 2, 2010. Comma is used to separate the expressions like yes, no, well, however, finally. For example, yes, I can help you. Well, he will not come.
Children, look at the apostrophe. You see the markup apostrophe. It is used to mark expression. It is Priya's book. For example, it is Priya's book. To shorten two words, it is also used to shorten two words. For example, cannot, can't, do not, don't. Children, when we use inverted commas, the inverted commas are used to tell the actual words used by a speaker. For example, Ramu said, "I am sorry." It is placed outside a full stop or question mark or explanation mark. Okay, children? ఇతరులు అన్న మాటలను అన్నట్టుగానే చూపించడానికి మనము ఇన్వర్టెడ్ కామాస్ వాడతాము. ఇట్ ఈజ్ ఆల్సో యూజ్డ్ టు ఇండికేట్ నేమ్ ఆఫ్ బుక్స్, ప్లేస్, సాంగ్స్, స్టోరీస్, టీవీ ప్రోగ్రామ్స్. ఫర్ ఎగ్జాంపుల్, హ్యావ్ యూ వాచ్డ్ రామాయణ్? ఐ హ్యావ్ రెడ్ అక్బర్ అండ్ బీర్బల్. హియర్ రామాయణం అండ్ అక్బర్ బీర్బల్ ఆర్ బుక్స్. So these books were kept in inverted commas. Children, look at the punctuation mark. What is this, children? Very good. This is a question mark. It is used after the questioning sentence. Children, when we use capital letters in the sentence, where we use? Now let us see the rules to use capital letters. Capital letter is used to begin a sentence. For example, there is a book on the table. The words there started with capital letter. The word I is always written in capital letter. For example, Roma likes apples, but I like mangoes. Capital letter is used to write the first word of a sentence written in inverted commas. For example, Sisit is my brother. Here, the word he started with capital letter H. Names of days and months also written in capital letter. For example, Monday, Friday, June, July, etc. The capital letter is written for proper nouns. Name of a person. For example, I want to talk to Ruby. Name of places. For example, cities, towns, villages, Delhi, Hisar, Warangal, like that. Countries, names of countries, names of continents, names of rivers, names of mountains, names of islands are written in capital letter. Names of subjects, buildings, books. Names of books starts with capital letter. Children, this is today's class, children. I am giving homework for you. You do it at home, children.